worried. I thought I was going to be talking in with a scientific crowd. So I said, I got to get some geek points. So I wanted to wear my lab coat. I got the bow tie. I got a pocket protector, which these are hard to find. I was going to even hang a slide rule on me, but, you know, I figured the millennials wouldn't even know what it was, so I probably wouldn't get any extra points. But it's good to be here today. Even though I have a PhD in management, I like to think of myself more of an MD, a management dude. So that's what we're going to talk about. And the nice thing about today's presentation is that this is something that applies to everybody in the audience. So even though I might not have invented a new solar car or something like that, this is something that you still be able to use today. See if I can use this correctly, we'll be okay. Okay, so federal processes, and I added the scope a little bit because the last slide I want to talk a little bit about the federal improvement team that I also am a part of. So what is Lean Six Sigma? You know, it's not like a Taekwondo or a karate, that's not why I'm wearing this master black belt, but it is a methodology that improves routine processes. And this technology is used in manufacturing, it's used in service industries, it's used in government, it's used all over in transactions. As a matter of fact, if you wanted to go into the car building business or a fast food business, you need this just as the price of admission to be able to get in, because your processes are what make you or break you in those applications. Applies to government. We are not different. We have customers. Some of them are internal, some of them are the general public. So it's good for us to know this. This is found throughout the federal workspace as well. As you see, we've got DOD, GSA, Department of Agriculture, Justice and Energy. They're all using this as well. So this is not just something that you're going to find at Toyota or General Electric or General Motors or Nike or Boeing or whatever. So this is very useful. As a matter of fact, it's very useful in a declining budget environment. This will help you do more with less. So I think it's pretty useful. So why would I want to use this Lean Six Sigma? And in a moment, I'll tell you about more about what it is. But a typical process that you're involved in probably has somewhere around 30 to 40% waste. It doesn't sound, you say, well, I'm pretty efficient. I know what I'm doing. You'd be surprised to find out how many things in the course of your routine day are extra things that are not really necessary. And they're causing you to take more time or cost more money to do something. You also get better results. We can cut costs, we can reduce your cycle time, like I've already said, and we can also eliminate some of the errors that your process may be giving you, and also maybe improve the quality of the product that you're putting out. There's also a people factor. You're coming to work every day, you're hating life, you know, I'm stuck in this bad process and I can't seem to change it. By improving our processes, you have a lot better morale in your organizations. And finally, workload. This is like getting maybe free labor or some free funding. So instead of taking 8 hours a day to do a particular process, maybe it only is going to take you six after you're done, and you get 2 free hours. Wouldn't it be nice to have more time in the day? I think I pumped up two. Okay. So how does it work? There's three particularly important fundamental parts of it. One of them is Lean, one of them is Six Sigma, and one of them is the theory of constraints. These are the three concepts that are put together and universally in Lean Six Sigma programs all over the world. Lean is a reduction of waste. A lot of us have waste in our processes. What is waste? Waste could be things like moving things around a lot or transporting it, shipping it back and forth, sending stuff out to Germantown and back. It could be inventory, keeping stuff just in case you need it. And meanwhile, you got a big storage problem. Trying to store all that stuff. Motion, unnecessary motion, having to go to different offices or go down across the street or whatever it might be. Waiting for things, that's waste. Over-processing. I always think that's kind of funny. You know, if you look at your remote your remote control on your television, you know, there's probably 42 buttons on there. I only need about maybe six, you know, on, off, louder, softer, channel up and down, and the other, you know, half a dozen or a dozen that's on there, I don't really need it. The customer isn't even interested in getting those features or paying for it. That's over-processing. Overproduction is producing too much of something. Defects, coming out with stuff that has to be corrected, reworking something. And the last one we call underutilization, which means you've got people that are really talented and they're doing menial tasks that you're paying them a lot of money to do. Second part of Lean Six Sigma is the reduction, Six Sigma, which is reduction of variation. You want to have your process give you a standard repeatable result every time. It shouldn't take, 5 minutes one time and then take 2 hours and 15 minutes the next time. You want something that's kind of, you can expect, you manage your expectations. And then the third part of it is a theory of constraints, which is reducing bottlenecks. Somebody or something that's slowing down, even, it's just like trying to drive home at night, I guess, during rush hour. Even though you've got very fast cars, you're sitting there and you're going very slow. So waste, variation, and bottlenecks, which is Lean, Six Sigma, and the theory of constraints. How do we do it? We use a very simple process known as DMAIC. Define, measure, analyze, improve, and control. And when we start out and we do one of these things, odds are almost 100% in your favor that you are going to find ways to improve the process and make it better. What's your problem? I know your project managers are probably enjoying this too, because a lot of this theory is very simple, not rocket science at all. Define what your problem is, measure what you're currently getting, analyze what your root causes of bad performance are, improve your process by testing new improvements to see if your new process is going to work. And then you go to the control phase where you implement it, you measure your results, and you lock it down. That's the new way of doing business. So define, measure, analyze, improve, and control. Here's another graphic along the same lines that kind of takes these same areas. Notice that each one of them has a little toll gate review. So at the end of each one, you stop and you give your presentation to the process owner and say, here's what we found in the define phase. This is what we're going to work on. Process owner says, okay, keep going. And then you just keep working your way down throughout the project. At some point, you might get to a point where you find out, well, that was the problem and we fixed it. They say, okay, stop, pull the plug. So you don't have to go all the way to the control phase sometimes, because sometimes you can fix the problem earlier. So define, measure, analyze, improve, and control. Who's involved? Well, we have formally trained practitioners that do Lean Six Sigma. You see these different colored belts here. They learn a body of knowledge, they get tested, they pass an examination, and then they can perform an improvement project. So our different levels of expertise is a yellow belt, which is somebody who we train just to be able to get on a project and be able to understand what's going on. They can spell DMAIC, they can spell Lean Six Sigma. Then we get a green belt. It takes maybe 1 week, or some programs have 2 or 3 weeks of instruction, teaching them basic tools to be able to lead a simple Lean Six Sigma project. We have a black belt, and they're capable of teaching, and they lead more complex projects. They have a lot more theory and statistics, and they actually have a toolbox that has close to 200 tools in it. So we have some black belts in the audience here, some of my colleagues. And then finally, a master black belt is what I'm wearing today, kind of for effect. And I mentor, I lead complex projects, even though I can't spell complex, and I certify belts. We also have sponsors who actually are there in the senior executive management, who kind of sponsor the project. We have process owners who own the process, and they have to make sure it gets done anyway. So they're really excited about getting their process fixed, and subject matter experts. Okay, so where is it being used in DOE? I love telling this story. This is like somebody saying, hey, tell me about your grandkids. This is the National Energy Technology Lab that here I'm certifying one of our green belts. But we've done something with site support contracts. We had a review process, and it was taking a very long time. And we were able to cut out some of the paperwork. We cut out some of the different stops that they had to get for approval and review. And we actually changed the cycle of evaluation, so they only do it on a yearly basis instead of semi-annually. Believe it or not, this particular process improvement probably saves us somewhere where $200,000 to $300,000 a year in people's time. So we consider that a really good cost savings. That's one of our best projects. We have one with chemical handling and procurement, which means we had technicians that were standing around up in the labs, and they're trying to fill out forms, and they're waiting in line to get some kind of chemical they needed to do their research. And we found a way to automate some of it. We set up a dispensary where the researcher would just come up, this is what I need, okay, thanks. It's kind of like getting your prescription at a pharmacy or whatever. I moved a lot faster. Again, some pretty good savings. Laboratory space assignment, that saved us a lot of money in just having to come back and rework spaces once they set up a lab. They found out, oh no, it had to be soundproof, or oh no, we needed to have certain light or vibration characteristics in the lab. So saved a lot of money in rework. One other one I'll mention, precious metal accountability and accounting. That was done and up at the labs up at Nettle. They use a lot of gold and silver in some of their experiments and whatever. And just even though we didn't save any money on that particular project, the fact that we had like 25 recommendations, it helped us become compliant with the handling of it, so we don't have a headline that says, the Department of Energy loses $1 million worth of gold or whatever. So there are some other things as far as compliance and accountability that can also be achieved by using a Lean Six Sigma program or project. And we have some exciting ones working right now with the funding opportunity announcements and investment review process. At headquarters, we've done some things with talent management, with onboarding, with budgeting processes, and with contracting processes, and we've improved some of those at FE. This has been an ongoing effort. And we have some other folks that we're working with at other sites that are also interested in doing some Lean Six Sigma. So when should it be used? It should be used now, because we have broken processes all over. Our office has the capability to train and certify members. If you're interested in perhaps getting some Lean Six Sigma training for a group of people, the only thing we ask is that you give them, have some kind of real project that they're going to work on. So as we're training them, we're also working through the project. As they're developing their charter and so forth, they're actually getting learning and they're also doing. So this is a pretty good strategy in a declining budget environment. One other group I want to talk about is the Federal Improvement Team. It's a group of government practitioners, a community of practice. Our vision is working smarter through continuous improvement. And we have a lot of the others that you saw their logos up there earlier. We actually 286 practitioners that are involved in these. We have two knowledge sharing events every year. We have a monthly lunch and learn. In fact, right now they're meeting on the phone for their monthly meeting. We share resources. We do projects, and some of them we're working with OPM, have done some training over there. So we're trying to spread this methodology, this wonderful thing that we have, and share it with others. So if anyone's interested in being in the Federal Improvement Team, that's available. So my takeaways from my particular presentation, Lean Six Sigma is a successful methodology to improve processes. Everybody has wasteful and broken processes, even some people here in the audience. Everybody has customers. Lean Six Sigma is just the price of admission in some industries. This works. You don't have to be making widgets. Government, it works too. Services, transactions. We use this a lot at the Coast Guard at their finance center in being able to pay bills faster. And also, you can use this and we can help you. So if there's any questions, give me a shout. But when I was teaching and learning Lean Six Sigma, I used to have to do teach backs. So I'm going to do a teach back for you now. That doesn't seem to be working. So I may need to go, okay, let's see why that's not working. Okay, so I need a boom, boom, clap, boom, boom, clap. Here, before we go, we need to do a review. If you got a bad process, I'm talking to you. When you got a bad process, you feel like you're stuck. You're hating your life. You got bad luck. To get rid of waste, we want to be lean. Cheaper, better, faster, that's a much better scene. We use Six Sigma to reduce variation. Good result every time, you'll be a sensation. Lose the bottlenecks, you're going too slow. If you speed up the process, you'll be saving more dough. Demaic's the plan to make it all happen. If you do it just right, your boss will be clapping. So process improvement will work for the feds. Work smarter, not harder, now we're using our heads. So thanks for listening, hope it wasn't too dry. If you got any questions, just ask Dr. Y. Okay, thank you very much.